to the work of Jesus, that Jesus did on the cross to give us a way of escape from the doom that is hanging over the whole earth.
所以我们听完这个话的意思是，凡是有耳的，我们都要听，听什么？听神的福音，啊，相信神的福音，领受主耶稣基督用自己救赎，就自己的宝血所换来的这个救赎的恩典，那么我们就可以逃脱将来要下永恒地狱的这个可怕的宿命。
This is why we can see this book is written to us who are living today before the Antichrist comes.
所以从这节经文里面，我们也看见启示录不仅仅是写给那个敌基督的年代的人，也是写给每一个有耳应当听的人。What
John is saying is that there is a way of escape given to us by Jesus. Believe it. That's what he said.
所以换句话说，约翰是说什么呢？是说主耶稣基督提供给我们一条逃生的道路。 我们可以逃脱这地狱之火，逃脱撒旦和敌基督的手的这么一条道路，但是是耶稣基督开的。Interesting,
right after verse 9. See, verse 9 is, if anyone has an ear, let him hear. And that hearing means believing.
第九节说，凡有耳的就应当听。听的意思不是什么，不是我听见了，我这个听的意思我听从了，那我相信了。And
then verse 10 is very interesting.
第十节就更有意思了。If
anyone is destined to captivity he goes. If anyone kills with a sword he must be killed. Here is the perseverance and faith of the saints.
在第十节说，掳掠人的必被掳掠，用刀杀人的必被刀杀，圣徒的忍耐和信心就是在此。
There is hope of escaping the doom. God, although there is hope of escaping the doom, God will allow His children to meet up with all kinds of troubles.
这个神已经这个赐下救恩，使得他的儿女呢可以逃脱永恒地狱的这个宿命。但是呢，神也允许他的儿女在地上经历很多的苦难和征战。
Some will go into captivity.
有的甚至会被掳去.
God will allow it.
神会允许神的百姓被掳去.
But don't worry.
但是我们不要惧怕.
God is still in control.
神在掌控当中.
We have to persevere in any situation that comes our way, trusting God all through.
我们要长久的忍耐. 要相信神，我们生命中无论发生什么样的状况、什么样的苦难和征战，神都在掌控当中，一切都是在神的手里。But
then it talks about the sword there.
然后呢，他就讲到这个刀的问题了。But
if we try to defend ourselves, we will suffer.
但是如果我们要为自己这个打抱不平，我们要用自己的能力保卫自己，我们就要被刀所杀。We
will suffer the same way we make our enemies suffer.
所以如果我们用刀杀我们的仇敌，最后我们要被我们的仇敌所杀。所以我们如何的行，我们将要同样的命，这个事情会临到我们。See,
Jesus is telling us, John is telling us, Jesus is in control. Trust Him.
约翰是提醒这个教会，耶稣基督掌控一切，不是教会，我们要相信主。Don't
trust yourself.
我们不能信靠自己，我们要信靠耶稣。Trust
Him in everything comes in from now right on through. Trust Him, and all those who will be here in this world when the Antichrist is here, they have to trust Him.
圣经说，我们凡事相信，凡事相信主。 要把一切的事情，万事万物都来到主的宝座面前，来到主耶稣的宝座面前。所以呢，哪怕是活在敌基督年代的人，他们一样是来到神的宝座面前，怀着信心，相信主，凡事凡物都要相信主。Now,
the next part, when I was writing this lesson, it seemed to me that the lesson just stopped there at verse 10.
我在备课的时候，我就觉得好像这个 这个课好像到第十节就结束了一样。
But then as I read 11 to 18, it was, there wasn't really too much more to say.
然后我又读了从十一节到这个最后一节十八节，我发现我没有需要再加多很多的这个解释了。
So it says this, and verse 11, and I saw another beast coming up out of the earth, and he had two horns like a lamb, and he spoke as a dragon.
在第十一节说，我又看见另有一个兽从地中上来，有两脚如同羔羊，说话好像龙。
Now this one says that he another beast coming up out of the earth. The first beast came up out of the sea.
前第一节的时候是说这个兽是从海中上来，现在第十一节说这个兽是从地中上来。
And in the Bible, there's no explanation of what the earth means.
圣经也没有交代这个从地中上来这个地是哪里。
And when I read the commentaries avoided trying to answer the question.
我看一些解经的书，这些解经家似乎也不太想去这个理到底这个地是什么意思，都好像没有什么解释。
But he had two horns like a lamb, and he spoke as a dragon.
有两脚如同羊羔，说话好像龙。
And he exercises all the authority of the first beast.
他在头一个兽面前施行头一个兽所有的权柄。
In his presence, I should have gone. And he makes the earth and those who dwell in it to worship the first beast.Whose fatal wound was healed.
他说呢，并且叫地和住在地上的人带那死伤医好了头一个兽。
And he performs great signs, so that he even makes fire come down out of heaven to the earth in the presence of men.
在第十三节说，这个的第二头兽呢，又行大奇事，甚至在人面前呢，叫火从天降在地上。
And he deceives those who dwell on earth.Because of the signs which it has, was given him to perform in the presence of the beast.
第十四节说，他因赐给他权柄，在兽面前能行奇事，就迷惑住在地上的人。
And telling those who dwell on the earth to make an image to the beast who had the wound of the sword and has come to life.
他说呢，迷惑地上人说，要给那受了刀伤还活着的兽做一个像。
And there was given to him to give breath to the image of the beast, and the image of the beast might even speak and cause as many who as do not worship the image of the beast to be killed.
第十五节说，又有权柄赐给他，叫兽像有生气，并且能说话，又叫所有不拜兽像的人都被杀害。
And he causes all, the small and the great and the rich and the poor, and the free man and the slaves, to be given a mark on their right hand or on their forehead.
第十六节说，他又叫众人，无论大小、贫富、自主的、为奴的，都在右手上或是在额上受一个印记。
And he provides that no one should be able to buy or to sell except the one who has the mark, either in the name of the beast or in the number of his name.
第十七节说，除了那受印记、有了兽名或有兽名数目的，都不得做买卖。
And here is wisdom. Let him who understands calculate the number of the beast, for the number of the beast, for the number is that of a man, and his number is 666.
第十八节，这是第十三章最后一节。在这里有智慧，凡有聪明的可以算计这个兽的数目，因为这是人的数目，它的数目是666。
Now that beast, that was the first beast, was not alone standing against Jesus.
这是第二头兽，所以呢，第一头兽实际上这两头兽，他们不是好像孤独的孤军奋战，正抵挡主耶稣基督，他们是一伙儿。
So John saw another beast rise out of the earth.
所以老约翰看见另一个兽从海中上来，从地中上来。
He works with all the authority of the first beast.
他在头一个兽面前施行头一个兽所有的权柄。
But he acts only as an advocate, for the first beast.
但是他实际上是在头一个兽面前呢，拜那史上医好的头一个兽。
And he is called the false prophet.
他被称为叫做什么呢？叫做假先知。
He does great miracles to deceive people into giving glory to the first beast.
他要行大奇事。 他行这大骑士以后呢，把这个第一头兽医好了以后，他就叫人去拜了第一头兽。
And he gets